We are on the Via Dolorosa, the Way of the Cross, having just left the Praetorium where Pilate stood to Christ. I washed my hands of the matter and turned him over to the people and told them to do what they would with him. There's no traffic here. The street's very narrow. Little children playing along the street. The street's about 10 feet wide. You can see the third station of the cross where Christ almost fell under the weight of the cross, is kneeling. And then the fourth station of the cross, on not over 40 or 50 feet farther toward Calvary, where his mother came up to him and said, "My son, what's happened?" And he's leaning under the heavy weight of the cross too. Continuing on now toward Calvary from the fourth station of the cross, we left the Praetorium where Christ was sentenced, or where he was turned over to the Jewish people, and they were offered Barabbas. And they said, "No, give us Christ, we'll crucify him." Following along the stations of the cross, passing station number 5. And it said at this point that Simon, a Cyrenian, coming out of the country, on him they laid the cross that he might bear it after Jesus. And they continued on the way of the cross. It's okay. They continued on the way of the cross as we are now, leaving place number 5 toward Calvary. It's a long, long way from here. You can see standing here between station number 5 and number 6, 200 yards at least up the steps toward Calvary's Hill. All along, it's a very narrow street, 10 or 12 feet wide. Shops on each side, little children playing, old men, old women, carrying their bread, dressed in the long robes, just as they did 2,000 years ago. The music here in the background is a radio playing, what's that, an Arab station? Still continuing up the way of the cross toward Calvary. The voices you hear in the background are pilgrims from all over the world. All along the Via Dolorosa here, there are beggars. I suppose mostly Arab beggars. Past station number 10, continue on to Calvary. They're all along the way. They say that they're all blind. They said that the reason there's so many blind along in this part of the country is because of the dust. Everywhere the wind is blowing and the dust is flying, and of course there's germs in the dust that diseases their eyes. The dust itself puts them out. On toward Calvary, passing other beggars sitting along the way, all kinds of shops. Pilgrims continuing on, same way that we're going. Now closer to Calvary, the way really gets crowded. Still the same very narrow street, though.